There was this soul I used to torture back in hell. And like a good masochist, he'd call the shot. Burn me. Freeze me. Hurt me. So, I did. And this went on for centuries. Until one day, for some reason, he missed his daily punishment. And when I returned, he was crying. "Please, my king," he said, "don't ever forget me again. I promise, I'll be good." It was then that I realized he was so full of self-loathing, void of any self-respect, that no matter the depth of my cruelty, whatever minuscule attention I paid gave meaning to his pointless existence. Why am I telling you this? Because he reminded me of you. You think I've changed. You, a former angel, powerless and pathetic. A disgraced failure with no better way than to spend your days than nipping at my heels for scraps. To remind you of a time when you once mattered.
Won't you spare me over till another year?
Journey with me into the breach once more, my friends, as we venture deeper into understanding angelic conjury to the world of magic. The information I'm sharing is by experience, and also from a book, a 400-year-old book, my father's book, an Earth Angel's book.
Well, what is this that I can't see? With I see hands getting hold of me. Well, I am dead, none can excel. I open the door to heaven and hell.
Wake up.
Spellcasting is for the unafraid. There are all sorts of delightful ways you can go about casting spells and charming, and there's no need for you to stick to just one or two methods. You should try them all. Experiment. Don't dabble with enchantments, though, unless you're very brave. But once the magical vibrations are set into motion, they can never be recalled. The power of magic is such that though you may be able to alter a spell's conclusion, you can never ever recapture what existed for you at the start. What charmed loves is a charm that will have a catalytic effect on all your personal relationships. It will project a romantic aura about you that love objects find exciting.
The practice of angelic conjuring comes in many forms. From divinational cards, scrying in the crystals, or even making sigil markings in the right order. When it comes to angelic conjuring, it's not how well you practiced. It's how strong you allow your feelings and emotions and self-awareness to become one. There are three requirements to angelic conjuring. Know thyself, have strong connection to your emotional feelings and self-awareness. Be brave and have strength within your own consciousness. Know thy purpose. When angelic conjuring occurs, there's no turning back. What purpose serves you for what you're conjuring and why? Know thy understanding. To understand who and why you are conjuring as an angelic being matters most. If you made it all the way to this point in the video, just know, no one has the right answers. No one knows it all. Only you can understand what you understand. And what you understand is by your experience and yours alone. If you think this chapter was pretty intriguing, you haven't seen anything yet. Just wait till chapter 9 when we discuss exorcisms. Leave a comment. Tell me what you think.